So hey guys, this is Sankew, and in this video, I'm going to share all the apps and services I've used in the last 1 year to get my work done as a freshman. Now, I know many people are going back to school or joining universities, so I decided why not make a back to school video, because I have not done something like this at all. And yes, drop some of the apps you have used to make yourself productive in the comments below. It'll really help me and the others who are watching this video. Before I start, the main thing with all the apps I use are they are cross-compatible with any platform. In the sense, they work on Android, Windows, macOS, or heck, even Chrome OS. And they sync well with all of them, which is an important thing for me, and it might be for you if you're not in an ecosystem like the Apple ecosystem. And also, all of the apps and services are free, if that matters to you. So let's start with the devices I use. And the first important thing for me is a laptop, and it's the M1 MacBook Pro. And if you haven't seen my review on it, do check it out, because if you're looking for a laptop to buy, this or the MacBook Air are such good deals in the laptop space right now. But anyways, other than a laptop, I use an iPad for attending classes when I'm away from my computer, or when I'm sleepy, or when I'm just plain bored using my computer every time. And I use two phones, which are the OnePlus 8 and the iPhone 7. And yes, I use an old iPhone for, you guessed it, making TikToks, Reels, Shots, and for the other stuff that are good on iOS. Yes, I'll admit iPhones are really good in like the social media stuff, but this video is not about that either ways. So without further ado, the first important app for me is Notion, which I know many people have talked about here on YouTube, but essentially it's an app that helps you keep track of your reminders and stuff. I mostly use it for writing down scripts for my videos and keeping track of what I have to submit. It's good in that, and alongside Notion, I mostly use Google Keep for some less important stuff. And I use both because, as I said in the beginning, I want everything to sync between all my devices. And it doesn't keep me locked down to a specific service. I'm looking at you, Apple Reminders. But anyways, both are equally good, and you can be good at using any one of them. It'll come in handy when you're trying to be very productive with the stuff you have to do. Alongside both Notion and Google Keep, I also use Google Calendar for quickly checking on what all classes I have in a day and if I have any exams that day. And the benefit of using Google Calendars is that, again, it syncs well with all my devices. Let's say you're using a Windows laptop and an iPhone, and you just want to use the native calendar app on both of them. With a single login to your Google account, you can use the Apple's native calendar app and the Windows calendar app on the devices, and they just sync together. Okay, so the next app is a weird one, and it's Alarm Me. And let's face it, we all like sleeping, and even if you hear your alarm ring, you still don't wake up. You just keep on snoozing it. So that's where Alarm Me comes in, and it's an alarm app that lets you turn it off when you complete a challenge. And for the snoozers like me, there's a time limit on how much times you can snooze your alarm. So let's say you reach your threshold of 3 snoozes, and you either let your alarm ring and annoy others, or you solve a challenge. I end up keeping the math ones or the take a photo ones, since both of them either make me use my brain early in the morning or make me walk up just to stop my alarm. It's a pretty useful app, not gonna lie. Anyways, other than those three, since I'm majoring in computer science, I use Visual Studio Code, which is a really good programming IDE, and it works with any language. It makes debugging quick, and I don't need to install multiple apps for all the programming languages out there, but rather just one IDE and a few extensions to get my work done. Well, let's say I want to debug a Python code. All I have to do is go install the Python extension from the extensions marketplace, and now I can debug the code. And there are tons of extensions like this and like productivity extensions on Visual Studio Code, and if you want me to do a video on it, drop them down below. I'll definitely do it. But other than that, if you're gonna start in computer science, definitely check out Visual Studio Code. And also, if you don't want to use an app and you want to run code on a pinch, there are always online IDEs, and one good one I've used is Online GDB. It can run code on any language, so if that's something you care about, check it out as well. Okay, so again about reminders. I cannot stop emphasizing about reminders, to be honest. We have sticky notes, and I'm not talking about these sticky notes, but rather the apps that you can use on your computers to get your stuff done. Let's say you're doing an assignment and you need to do a lot of things, or you have to keep track of what all you have to do on an assignment. And that's where these sticky notes come in, and you can note down what all you have to do on an assignment, and you can quickly include them as soon as you're done. These are built into macOS and Windows as sticky notes, and if you're using an iPad instead of a laptop, you can definitely use the Notes app in Side View to do your stuff. Speaking of typing out assignments, let's talk about productivity software. There are a couple of options out there, ranging from free to being paid, and obviously I would recommend you stick with the free ones. And I do have a video coming up soon about this, so stay tuned, but other than that, my recommendations would be the Google suit or the iWork suit, which are free and very good. Now, mind you, the iWork suit only works on Apple devices, so keep that in mind. Or even if you're just used to using Microsoft Office all these years, there's an online version which is free, but it's kind of limited compared to all the apps which I just said above right now. But they get the job done if that's very important for you. Now, as most of my work also relies on a browser, I use both Safari and Chrome. Now, I can stick to just using one, but I use both mainly for three reasons. The first reason is Safari is just fast at anything on my laptop, especially the M1 MacBook Pro. Everything opens in an instant. But the second and third reasons are bummers for sure. Safari is just quite limited compared to Google Chrome. And third one is that Safari is the only browser which doesn't work on my Android phone. So that's where Google Chrome comes in, and I mostly don't use a lot of extensions, but the extensions I use are TubeBuddy, vidIQ, Grammarly, Honey, Metastream, and finally Dark Mode. Anyways, for most people, TubeBuddy and vidIQ are not necessary at all, as they are mainly for my YouTube channel. And it helps me search for keywords, check how my video will rank and what topic will rank if I do a video on it, and mostly copying tags from other YouTubers. Apart from those two, I'm pretty sure the others are pretty useful. Starting with Grammarly, which is a writing assistant, and trust me, you don't need Grammarly for your university work or just your school work. You may never know where you make mistakes and stuff. For example, let's say you're in a hurry trying to finish an assignment that's due tomorrow. You are less bothered about making mistakes and finishing the thing right now. And that's where Grammarly comes in. It can save you time with suggestions for your mistakes. I'm pretty sure if you have written enough stuff for your school, you will have a good idea about Grammarly. And I use Grammarly for not just doing assignments, but also for correcting the small grammatical mistakes I make along the way when I'm typing out scripts for my YouTube videos. Yes, I do make mistakes and I'm not ashamed of it. And so should you. But anyways, it's a useful app for students and writers alike. Okay, next up is Honey, which helps you save on your online purchases. Say you want to buy a table and you think the table is priced really high. So Honey will come in and try to search for discount codes for the table you're trying to buy or just for the entire site. And if it finds the best discount code, it'll apply it on its own. It's pretty good, and if you want to save a lot of money during college, which you should definitely do use Honey for your online purchases. Okay, next up, Metastream, and it's not a productivity extension, but something that helps you and your friends watch anything together. Let's say, for example, you and your friends want to watch something, but since everything is online, you guys cannot watch together. So that's where Metastream comes in and basically lets you watch any type of video together. And it also allows you to chat alongside. It's a pretty neat extension for just hanging out with your friends. Lastly, there's Dark Mode, and it's an extension that, you guessed it, makes websites dark. Now, when you're working up all night, you're definitely going to get a jump scare looking at light mode on any website. And let's just say you hate light mode like me for no reason. And that's where Dark Mode comes in and makes any website dark with a flip of a button, regardless of any condition. If you want to go in depth, you can also enter your own CSS colors to make your own variation of dark. It's useful when you're browsing and the website you're looking at is currently not made with Dark Mode in mind. But do keep in mind, sometimes a few elements get hidden because what this extension essentially does is inverts the colors of your website. So keep that in mind. Other than that, if you can, try taking up courses from either Coursera or Udemy, who both offer certificates as soon as you complete a course. And trust me, building an extra skill is just gonna place you ahead of everyone in your field, if that's something that matters to you. And if you're in the computer science program like me, learning an extra programming language and building things out of it is just gonna add more stuff to your resume, which will help you land in more jobs or internships easily. Usually these courses on these sites are paid, but if you're lucky, they do offer a few courses for free on random times. I got this Python 3 course from Udemy for free during the new year, so keep that in mind and look for free offers when you can. And if you don't want to pay for any course, just look for free options. As always, links to everything I use is in the description below, but one thing to keep in mind is, check out all the apps I've suggested, but just shortlist a few that you think you can use and commit to and track regularly. Lastly, no matter how much apps you use, in the end, they're just helping hands, and you have to do all the efforts yourself. And these all are useless without self-motivation, so be self-motivated and don't keep big targets to yourself. You're on the right track if you just complete 70% of the daily tasks you think about doing in a day. Just don't make long lists and procrastinate. This is Sankew, and I'll see you guys in the very next video. Peace.